Several Philippine lawmakers are calling out what they say is a lack of funding for the country's pandemic response after the House approved the national budget for next year. Voting 267-6 last Friday, the lower chamber approved the proposed 4.5 trillion peso spending plan on third and final reading. Gabriela Partilis Representative Arlene Brosa says the budget contains so-called multiple infra pork slices worth 397 billion pesos, said to be triple the amount set aside for the health department. Let's ask Congressman Mike Defensor, who joins us this morning. Good morning, Congressman Defensor, and thank you for joining us, sir.
Yes, good morning, Christian, to all the viewers. Magandang umaga po sa inyo lahat.
Before we talk about the budget passed on third and final reading last Friday by the lower house, let's talk about your status at the house. What happens to you now after the change in leadership?
Well, Christian, to be honest, I'm not sure. We have made several changes. Meron mga napalitan na. Pero wala pa naman nasasabi tungkol dun sa particular na sa committee ko, Committee on Public Accounts. We have not heard from the speaker about it. Pero as I've said, no, the speaker has a free hand. Technically naman, it's not an appointed position. It's still an elected position. But of course, the speaker will choose amongst his supporters kung sino yung gusto niyang mapunta dito sa mga committee to, particular dyan, no, yung appropriation, which is very critical, ways and means, the committee on accounts of the House, and after which they nominate whoever will be elected. So okay naman sa akin yan, whatever will be the decision. But as of now, we just finished the budget. Supposedly nga may committee hearing ako today for PhilHealth, but the speaker requested, along with Majority Leader, Speaker Lord and the Majority Leader Martin requested that there will be a break of a week, 1 week, para mag-regroup and for them to prioritize the prioritized legislation that we need to adopt.
But in your case, would you like to keep your position?
Depends. Technically, the speaker, again, very critical in my committee, public accounts to, maraming niimbestigahan, and you need to have the support of the speaker. So, depende yan kung ano yung direksyon niya. But as to the job that I have done in the past and that will continue to do, handa naman ako dyan. Katulad na sinabi ko, PhilHealth, we're just finishing it now. Tapos, supposedly, sisimulan ko yung investigation on the telcos dahil may order ng presidente during the SONA to them for them to improve the signal. And, well, supposedly, we will be coordinating with the NTC and the DICT in discussing this. So,
okay. But for the record, Congressman Defensor, were you among those who voted in favor of Speaker Velasco during the start of the special session?
Christian, for the record, I supported Martin Romualdez during last year. He lost.
Yeah.
Speaker Cayetano won. In the term extension of Speaker Cayetano, I supported him. He lost. And Speaker Lord Velasco is now the speaker. But during the voting, wala na naman kami actual voting eh. He just went up to the rostrum and parang nagkaroon na lang ng, how can I say it? Parang
adoption, right? Or ratification of the vote.
That was the process na siya na talaga yung speaker.
Mm. So you're now, you are, for the record, supporting the new speaker?
Yes. Ako naman, sinabi ko naman dati pa eh, di ba? It's the institution. You have the leadership of the House. But I also understand, kung nakita niya na I was on the other side and he feels that he's more comfortable with another person, then I can accept that. Yung politika, isang araw lang yan eh. Pero ang importante, yung trabaho namin sa House, how best can you effectively conduct yourself, yung mga trabaho namin, no? Kung kahit na anong support mo sa kanya, kung hindi mo naman kayang i-approve yung mga batas sa ways and means, yung mga kailangan nating tax measures, yung mga kailangan batas para ayusin yung ating ekonomiya, palakasin yung ating mga negosyo. So, hindi din naman pwede yun. In the same manner, in the appropriations deliberations, kailangan din yung marunong sa budget, yung ilalagay mo so that we will be able to approve and to improve what is submitted to us by the executive. Ito yung, di ba, yung NEP. And then we amend it kung ano yung tama at nakikita namin dapat baguhin.
Then the GAB, the General Appropriations Bill. Now, I'm asking you these questions because during that Facebook Live message by former Speaker Cayetano, he mentioned leaders or officials under his watch. Basically, it might be construed as a team of then Speaker Cayetano. He basically made an appeal to the new Speaker to make good on his promise to keep those posts. And I suppose Speaker Cayetano was referring to the likes of you because you're among the several congressmen who were very close to him during his term. So was there even an agreement to begin with that you guys would be kept in your positions under Speaker Velasco?
Okay, Christian, I don't think I'm one of those. Kasi ako, nabigyan ako ng committee huli. I was the last one probably given by Speaker Alan Cayetano a committee in the House. I think one of the last two. So that was maybe three months after he was elected. I think Speaker Cayetano was talking about the leadership in terms of the Deputy Speaker, in terms of the appropriations, the ways and means, the critical committees in the House. Why? Because when he started this duty as Speaker, nung siya ma-elect, nilagay niya na yung iba't ibang mga tao eh. Nagkaroon na doon nung supporters ni Speaker, ni Majority Leader Martin Romualdez, yung supporters ni Speaker Lord Velasco. So they, parang nagkaroon na sila ng mix at the time. Parang nga doon sa transition, huwag na magkagulo. Supposedly, that was the idea. So I would think that was the appeal of Speaker Alan Cayetano na kung pwede, huwag na natin baguhin yung mga existing supposedly deputy speakers and some of the chairpersons of the critical committees kasi nga sana magtuloy-tuloy na yung at kanilang trabaho and that the transition will not affect the organization of Congress.
But is that even plausible to say that you were not part of that group of then Speaker Cayetano? But I remember you were among those several congressmen who were front and center in some of the issues that he actually aggressively pushed for, including the killing of the franchise application of ABS. You're among the congressmen who were very much visible and vocal.
Yes, yes. But you know, if you talk about the organization of the House, my committee is, I would think it's a strategic committee, but it's not part of the leadership of the House. Meaning to say, yung pinag-uusapan lang when they speak of not changing yung organization of the House, you have, what, 24 deputy speakers divided amongst the different followers. Many of them, like, you saw it, di ba? Yung kay Speaker Lord Velasco, may mga deputy speakers na sumama sa kanya and campaigned for him. May mga kasama sa Rules Committee, which is very critical, no? The Rules Committee is the one running Congress, na parang yun ang tingin kong tinitingnan na wag guluhin. Because, you know, if you're, for example, a chairman of an ex-committee or you're a junior in these committees, I don't think that would be a critical position in relation to the organization of Congress.
But how you got that position in the first place was, I won't say extraordinary, but as you've mentioned, you were not actually supportive of Speaker Cayetano at the start, di ba? But even then, as a member of a partyless group, you got that strategic chairmanship, public accounts.
Yes, people may say that, but as I've said, I don't think it's a major component of Congress. Pagka pinag-usapan natin yung organization ng Kongreso, like if you're, even if you're the president, diba, you're talking of ways and means, which is to have the, what do you call this?
Revenue.
Taxes and revenues of the government. Appropriations is very critical sa allocation ng mga budget.
Committee on Justice also.
Committee on Justice, yes, it's major, but not in the sense of the agenda of the president. For example, when you talk about the COVID now, yung niline up ni Presidente na mga during the State of the Nation address, what are the critical laws that should be approved because it's needed to address the pandemic issue, marami dyan, hindi naman kasama yung ibang committee, hindi kami kasama. So, ito yung basically, but yes, if you consider the Public Accounts Committee and Good Government are as critical committees in the sense that you know, they're conducting investigations, marami siyang ginagawang pag-aaral dun sa mga ibang mga gawain ng mga departamento, then I would think so, pero depende. But your question was yung point ni Speaker Alan about the reorganization, I would think it was more centered and focused on those critical positions and in relation to the national economy and to the national development.
But for the record, was there any agreement between the two to keep those critical positions you've mentioned? Or there was
alam
none?
Mo, yeah, Christian, to be honest, lahat ng agreements na wala akong alam eh. They started in July, they had an agreement. They had a meeting again. And I was supposed to be there but I was not able to go. again, when they were having an agreement, I think the four of them, the President, Speaker Lord Velasco, Speaker Alan Cayetano, and Senator Bongo, were separated themselves from the rest. Nagkaroon sila ng maliit na pag-uusap. Pagkatapos itong last meeting nila, where Speaker Cayetano spoke before Facebook, nag-Facebook Live siya, again, it was a confidential meeting amongst themselves. So, ang sabi nila, may ganun daw. But, you know, I'm not privy to any of those discussions. Mm.
Now, by the way, let's go to the issue of the budget deliberations because that was passed on third and final reading last Friday. But the submission would still have to wait. And I think today is a deadline for the small committees, or for the small committee to accept amendments. Is that even allowed under the law or under the rules?
Because, Christian, the process in Congress is that you have about 300 members. If all of us will be debating about a certain amendment on certain provisions of the budget, o lahat ng yan merong mga sariling gusto. For example, no, the district congressmen, may mga gusto silang ipasok or gusto nilang increase ang budget on a certain project. Magiging magulo. So it has been like that. I was there in the 10th and 11th Congress. I was part of the small committee na pinuput together namin yung mga amendments. Some of them are policy amendments. Some of them are institutional amendments. May mga maliliit, no? May mga kailangan sila na mga particular na proyekto. Tinitingnan din yun ng small committee. And hindi naman yun totally ini-ignore. For example, in my case, no, I've been saying this for the past several weeks. And ako naman, in the budget deliberations, nakafocus talaga ako sa health. Na ang sinasabi ko dito, yung 2.5 billion for the vaccine is not enough. Kailangan natin to increase to 20 billion. And I hope that they will be able to amend the budget. Kasi sabi nila, 2.5, tapos pag may kailangan pa, increase na lang natin and we will be able, we'll just borrow for that. But ang ko, as early as now, it should be part of the budget.
But how
the
do
vaccine,
you... Yeah.
And we need to have a budget for that.
And I think a lot of your colleagues are also supportive of that, increasing the budget for the acquisition of vaccines when they become available. But speaking of the small committee, what's a safeguard of the public against possible abuses? Because technically, the budget has already been passed by the lower house on third and final reading. So how do we know whether there are certain insertions which were not part of the discussions during the period of debate and amendments?
Yes, Christian. Well, for one, the executive will know if what they submitted and what is now being approved or being deliberated on is different from the original. Ang executive naman allows it eh, di ba? Meron naman, yeah. If we say 2.5, sinabi natin, increase natin yung vaccine to 20 billion, okay yan. Pero pag nakita na nila na medyo naging parochial na yung treatment, no? And hindi na siya institutional amendments, and we have seen that in the past, not only with President Duterte when he vetoed the budget, marami na naman din nangyari nung mga nakaraan na nag-veto pagka hindi naging maganda na yung naging forma ng budget. And of course, the BICAM with the Senate will be there. It's another check. They would have to discuss it. And then after which, it goes to the President for the final approval. So, marami naman checks and balances para dito. And hopefully, tama ka, wag naman maging... I'm confident, no? Congress will be able to do it. Ang worry ko lang naman kasi, baka mamaya mangyari ulit yung dati. Na, you know, they were looking at it, they were looking at what is there, and then all of a sudden, they put certain budgets there na nagkagulo-gulo na, may mga natanggalan. Then that's a problem.
How is this small committee different from the committee that was formed when you guys were still in power under Cayetano? Except for the composition. I know the composition changed a bit.
Yes. Christian, I was never part of the small committee.
No.
It was all...
I mean, under the sphere of influence of Speaker Cayetano then.
Yeah, but well, I'm not really sure how they functioned then. No, but there were... The Appropriations Committee was functioning, in fact. Let me go years before. Yung small committee kasi we sit down, we discuss kung ano yung mga... Like for me, I was in charge of the provisions, special provisions, and also some questions on policy. So I was the one looking on that, ano yung lengguwahe ng budget. Kasi hindi lang naman siya numero eh. Marami siya mga provisions, particularly on... for example, ako, sa health, I would support the HFEP, yung Health Facilities Enhancement Program, na medyo maging... lenient on the bidding process. Why? Because, kunyari, bibili ka ng x-ray machine, hindi naman ibig sabihin pinakamura, pinakamaganda. You know, you would have products from China or elsewhere na maring inferior to a product from Germany or the US. So, it could be part of the special provision. But anyway, going back here, first time I was, yung small committee ni Speaker Cayetano, we sat down one day. And then later on sila, Speaker Lord na ang pumasok, and I saw the list already. I think there are about 20 people involved now in the small committee. And I'm sure they'll be discussing, number one, the local concerns, number two, policy, and then number three, institutional amendments. So basically, ito yung mga yan that will look at the numbers and look at the provisions of the budget.
But in terms of the process, how is it different from the timetable that you guys fixed at that time when Speaker Cayetano was still in power? Because there was also the small committee, and then, of course, you were supposed to submit the printed budget to the Senate on November 16. So in this case, how is it different? Natapos din naman during the special session last Friday.
Ang alam ko, we were able to forward it last year. And sa ngayon naman, we're not out of schedule. Landong pa rin naman niya sa time frame. Ang importante talaga, maiangat ka agad sa Senado at mapag-usapan nila at magawa ka agad yung BICAM. So I think no, we're okay, we're in time. Ang magiging problema natin dyan, Christian, I guess not only a warning for everyone but for all of us, pagka medyo nagkaroon ng malaking mga pagbabago na hindi na in consonance with what the executive want. And if that happens, then you would have a vetoed budget. Pero kung hindi naman, at pantay ayos naman yung more or less no, what they submitted to us and what was approved, then I don't see any problem.
Okay, Congressman Defensor, thank you for joining us, sir.
Thank you, Christian. Gandang umaga.